New York City, October 2012. Hurricane Sandy left more than 8 million customers without electricity. But in some hospitals, universities, waste treatment plants, and residential complexes, the lights stayed on. How'd they keep the power running? The answer to that question has big implications for America's manufacturing sector and for any institution that needs a reliable, efficient, and cost-saving source of electricity. Today, nearly two-thirds of the fuel that is used to generate power escapes as waste heat, usually through cooling towers. However, if we recapture that lost energy, we can use it to create more electricity, or to warm or cool nearby buildings. We can do that by using proven technologies that are nearly twice as efficient as most systems, such as combined heat and power, or waste heat recovery to improve industrial productivity. And combined heat and power is highly resilient. It proved its reliability after Hurricane Sandy and Katrina, and the blackout that swept across the Midwest and Northeast in 2003. Sounds pretty good, right? That's why many American factories, hospitals, colleges, and commercial buildings rely on combined heat and power. So many, in fact, that it already generates 12% of electricity in the United States. By improving efficiency, these companies and institutions also save on energy costs. But we could go even further. Adopting more of these technologies could help America's industrial sector attract more than $200 billion in new investment and add as many as 1 million high-skilled jobs. And along the way, manufacturers and institutions will be better prepared for severe weather. So let's stop wasting energy. Harness the heat today to make American manufacturers more efficient and globally competitive.